Okay, now we are going to move to Allan Alaküla, cap de l'oficina de la Unió Europea de Tallinn, Ajuntament de Tallinn, y Bona Pràctica EPSA. A pleasure to have you here.
Thank you. My screen is actually not too healthy, so maybe I have to stare at my neighbor's screen. But okay. So, Tallinn became, I think, most known in recent years with its free public transport, and it really is an issue from Tallinn, I think, with a comparable magnitude of the Olympic regatta, maybe from 13-year-old history of 1980. So we haven't had such a meaningful issue after it, and with a good reasons. Free public transport is evidently not the omnipotent thing what resolves all the issues, including health in the cities. But it's definitely the thing what addresses simultaneously health, social considerations, economic stimulation, and definitely environment, and not last importance, the fiscal side of the urban life. So some orientation, orientational figures about Tallinn. Population slightly and constantly increasing, and the last number is 440,000 residents. The city budget 600 million euros. Bus fleet, public transport fleet altogether nearly 500. Units includes buses mostly, but also trams and trolleybuses. Public transport budget increased since free public transport was implemented, increased considerably, becoming up from 53 to 61 million. So about 1/10 of the city budget goes to the public transport. Ticket revenue before the shift to the free public transport used to be 17 million, and out of this 17 million, 12 million was ticket revenue from Tallinn residents. So the cost of free public transport for Tallinn city is roughly estimated 12 million. It's evidently more than 40,000 for a cycling lane, but also the fiscal return is evidently bigger, but I come to it. So the main objectives for doing free public transport in Tallinn were social aspects, it's mobility for all, for those with medium incomes, below the medium, which both are the case in Tallinn, affordability, economic aspects, the promoting and increasing the mobility has an evident stimulus for local economy, stimulating consumption of local goods and services. People are going out more in the evenings, on weekends, to consume. Green aspects, evidently, which includes also, we can combine easily with health aspects. It's modal shift from cars. And fiscal aspects, it's and that's a solution in Tallinn, fiscal solution, how it became possible. It's increasing number of taxpayers in a city, providing free public transport for residents, brought to us meaningful increase of the taxpayers, number of taxpayers. And as a result, city budget gained from it. It wasn't expense. The technique, how it was done, we started from referendum in 2012, March. All residents were enabled or were eligible and were asked if you would like to have free public transport implemented on Tallinn municipal public transport network. It was predictable, easy to predict. Answer, 75% of those attended said yes, 25 were against. The reason for having a referendum wasn't to know what people think. We knew it, there was no doubt about. And if you ask wherever, probably pretty similar result will occur. 3/4 of people are in favor of free public transport. We learned it also from China, but also it's in European context, it's so evident. But the reason of having referendum was to involve people to decision making, and even more important, it was to lock the decision politically as strongly as possible, because you can't make this step for only for half or even for one electoral term. You can't play with it, and that's why you need as strong as possible insurance, political sustainability of the decision. And this was received from the referendum. And so from 1st January of 2013, after the council passed the decision, referendum wasn't legally binding, the council is to decide. And the city council decided to shift to free public transport from 1st January 2013. So now we have it 3.5 year ongoing free public transport in Tallinn city limits for Tallinn residents, in Tallinn municipal public transport network. Plus, it has been extended to the trains, nationally operated trains in the city limits. So almost all public transport modes in the city are free, except regional and intercity buses. Preparatory steps were taken. The most important was a severe expansion of the exclusive or dedicated bus lanes, which was not possible even to consider seriously without having had a referendum. Referendum was interpreted much wider than just implementing or just shifting free public transport. It was implemented as a full priority, full green light for developing public transport, and expanding the bus lanes network was definitely based. The political mandate was interpreted from the results of the referendum. If you look on length of the bus lanes, it wasn't so drastic. It was increased from 15 to 23 kilometers, but most important was that the bus lanes trespassed now the city center, where the jams are and where. So we really made the trespassing city center bus lanes, and this really made difference in bus public transport speed and attractiveness. And we implemented also contactless card to get a proper accountability of the ridership, and as I told, as it is only for residents, so we needed better tools. And we have had fine ID ticket before, but it did not provide a usage, real entrances, real trips number. So as a result of starting free ride for residents, the registered population of the city started to increase in the beginning very sharply, but it continues to increase. It's still major stimulus for new people to register as a Tallinn residents. It's pretty much the case with many other main cities in different member states, that there are a lot of residents not registered. They stay registered in their previous places of living. But if municipality is able to provide attractive attractions or stimuluses for registration, people do it. And as a result, city population increased, now we say, around 25,000 by 25,000 residents. Our rough calculation says every 1,000 new registered people bring 1 million to city budget. So And remember, 12 million was the cost of the free public transport of implementation for the city. Then it's covered with safe surplus. Most of the surplus that was earned from the increase of tax money was directly invested to the quality of public transport, to the renewing of the fleet, renewing of the tram rails and tram fleet. So the increase of the public transport budget from 51 to 63, it's also mostly covered from this increase of the money. So we were able to provide free service, but we were able to substantially improve also the quality, and it all at the expense of increase of the number of taxpayers. In the mobility, the results were modest. Roughly estimated 10% increase in ridership in number of trips, which is not comparable to any other case of the cities where free public transport was implemented. It's usually in European, in French cases, when it's implemented, it multiplies several times, and up to 10 times is usual figure what we see. In Tallinn, only 10% plus, and even this with reservations, as we have a major tram network rebuilding. The main explanation is that we have had already before free ridership for 65 plus population, and the EOS students and EOS below 18 also had so big discounts that they most of them were able to afford it before. So it wasn't really drastic change for EOS and for 65 plus population. So we still admit the increase in ridership is remained modest. However, it was pretty much predicted. The worst prediction from the administration was the expected increase was 15%. No, so we were ready up to the increase of the 15%. We got 10. No, we would wish a bit more, but we are still fine with it. What has been even more remarkable, however, was the drastic change in the private car ownership. While before, the free public transport was implemented in Tallinn and then the counties surrounding Tallinn, Golden Circle around the city, there was an annual private car ownership increase around 10%, which is, everybody understands, drastic increase. In 2013, suddenly, in Tallinn, the private car ownership almost halted. The increase was 0.6, but it below 1%, sharply. But in county around Tallinn, it continued with the previous speed, and still continues about 10%. So it still the time is a bit short to be confident in conclusions. But let's say the sharp change occurred in Tallinn and in surrounding, in private car ownership. In traffic, however, the shift is not so evident. However, in city center, the traffic we have traffic cameras, so it's hard data, decreased by 6%. But in city total, it wasn't so good. In suburbs, traffic even increased. So we pressed traffic a little out from city center, which has been pretty much a goal. Increase in suburbs wasn't desired, but it occurred too. And maybe it's worth to notion also, it was in a, especially the decrease of traffic in city center was combined and was pretty much caused by the sudden increase of parking tariffs. It has been undertaken 1 year after free public transport was implemented. So city got an argument that, okay, you don't like heavy parking tariffs, but we have a public transport free. So it's a kind of answer for it. But everybody admits the parking tariffs in Tallinn city center, in Old Town particularly, are I think we have the most expensive parking tariffs in Scandinavia. But in continent as well, it's I doubt if anybody has this nearly €5 hour in Old Town. It's heavy, and in considering to our incomes, it's even more heavier. But still the spaces, parking spaces, are not that the surplus is not too big still. So the even income from the parking increased as well. But to the total number of traffic in city center, it had a good and desired impact. And Tallinn did not came to the free public transport out of blue. So we have had before us many examples and the knowledge of free public transport, mostly from France. It was definitely for us was model, which is not anymore, Hasselt in Belgium, in Flemish part, but also several cases in Sweden and elsewhere in the world, in Chengdu in China as well. And so Tallinn raised the flag of the free public transport cities network. We have had several international events for exchange of for better practices, best practices. And we initiated also events in Poland and last year in Sweden. And I would say this networking started to produce results, started to have an impact. And in France, however, the oldest cases and let's say non-stop or constant cases who started free public transport are from the early 70s, already from mid 70s, some towns. But in France, we now know that Dunkirk, with 200,000 residents, declared they will have free public transport since beginning of 2018. So they took time, they are preparing, but they are committed to it. So it will be twice as big to the previous biggest French free public transport city. Now the biggest is Aubagne, city, urban area, with roughly 100,000 residents. Dunkirk is doubling the biggest city in population. And the last news came from last week, a new mayor of the Bucharest, Mrs. Firea, also declared that the Bucharest, capital of Romania, population nearly 2 million, well above a million at least, is going to have a free public transport. It will be definitely, and Tallinn will be most happy to hand over the flag of capital of free public transport to Bucharest if that will be the case. So about what should be maybe should have been in beginning, but it's important to note that there is no universal definition of the free public transport yet. There is even ongoing and heavy discussion between the academicians if it should be called a free public transport or fair free public transport. But the objectives and the modes and the techniques of having and implementing free public transport remain pretty different. The scope of the implementing free public transport remain different. in Tallinn, as you know, it's not only for residents. In quite many French cities, it's free for all, but not in all French cases as well. There are several cases also for residents only. There are cities where free public transport is only in some city districts, like Chengdu, which has free public transport lanes around the second ring road, so only feeding lines are free. Plus, in Chengdu, all terrestrial public transport before the morning peak from 5 to 7 a.m. So on time-wise and district-wise, there are quite many cases in U.S. cities where there are some lines trespassing the city center, some ring lines are free. So no universal definition yet occurred. What might be seen as universal, it's that the people everywhere like it. And then people really, really are happy with it elsewhere. And our figures also in Tallinn with satisfaction service with public transport indicate that people are really, really, the satisfaction with the service increased. And this was maybe the main risk and main fear before the implementation, that we can't maintain the service quality. As a result, we were able to invest more, renew the fleet, and really improve the quality of the service. And so we get at this stage, after 3.5 years, we don't have any discussion about continuation of free public transport. In 3 years it became normal. It's about the council. There is nobody is able to go in public to start discussion over changing or returning to paid public transport. People used to good things very quickly, and that's definitely the case with our free public transport. And you can find all the conferences materials which I referred to, and then news and media coverage from dedicated web page. Thank you. Was it too quick? All right.